Hello students, myself Shabadavan, and now I am going to teach you lesson number 15, probability. Okay, see, I have started already with the basic concept which was uploaded for you. It is showing about the throwing of dice, coin, and about the cards. Okay, this I have sent especially just for your reference, because sometimes they may ask the question related to them. In this year you are learning the probability for the first time. So here is only the experimental approach. First we will understand what is the meaning of probability. See, you have heard that on tossing of a coin in a cricket match, the possibility of winning and losing is equal, 50-50. Ho sakta hai jeet jaye, ho sakta hai haar jaye. Okay. Similarly, agar hum kehte ki aaj badal bahut chha gaye hain, barish hone wali hai, we have a probability, that is the chances that it may rain. Okay. There is also a doubt that sometimes if he is not studied well, there is a doubt he will not pass an exam. So that doubt, chances, assumption, these all words are the synonyms of the probability. Okay? So daily life we are using it. It is also used mostly in gambling. Gambling, jisme khela jata hai, tab hume andaza nahi hota ki kya karna hai, kya nahi karna. But now, mathematics, we are using probability for the better reason, and we are understanding what is the concept. It's very easy. In 2-3 lecture only you will understand what is probability. Also, this is also used in other fields in which I have given you PPT also, that is physics, sociology, biology. There also there are chances that it may happen or it may not happen. So accordingly we are using probability. Okay, this year, because you are learning it for the first time, we are just learning about the experimental approach. Okay, as probability and experimental approach. If your school was learning regular basis, we had an activity, but now it's not possible. So you can do it by yourself at home, and if it chances get a time, we will do it in our school also. That is, it is given in the form of groups, where one group of suppose 5 students have been given one coin, and they have been told to toss it for the 5 times, and they will get some outcome. It is been recorded. That is on throwing of dice. Suppose I am talking about the throwing of coin first. Okay, throwing of coin, we are just, you can call it as tossing also. Tossing of coin or throwing of coin, we get possibilities either head or tail. Okay, the first group has recorded, they are getting 3 times head and 2 times tail. Second group of 5 students are getting 1 time head and suppose 4 times tail. All are breaking 5 times. Now third group, they are having suppose 2 times head and 3 times tail. And fourth group, they are having all the 5 times head and no tail. Okay? So here we have 4 type of outcomes. That is total how much possibilities? 5, 10, 15, 20. So we have 20 students who have 20 times the coin has been tossed. And what is the total possibility of getting head? 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. That is 11 times I got head, 10, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That is 9 times I got tail. Okay. Now head is 11 times tail. So I can write here possibilities of head is 11 and tail is 9. Okay. So first probability of E, A. I am taking A for head. That is head equals to 11 times. Therefore, 11 upon total is 20. This is the first one. And probability B, that is getting tail, is how many times? 9 times. So it will be 9 upon 20. Now we have only 2 possible outcomes. This is zyada nahi hoga, this is kam nahi hoga. Total outcomes are either head or tail. So if we add it, PA plus PB is equal to, we will see 11 by 20 plus 9 by 20. 11 plus 9 is 20 by 20. Final value is 1. That means sum of all the probabilities. Agar humne koi event chhod denge to 1 nahi aayega. But if we are taking all the events, it will sum up to 1. Okay? Clear this much? This I have 34 one point. We can talk about the dice also. Same thing, if we allot one group and we have given them a dice, we told them to write the recordings, whatever the recordings they are getting, and then after that we can sum up like this and just write the values. How many times I got? 1, how many times I got 2, how many times 3, how many times 4. We can take a table like this. And from that table, we can get the values. Like is getting the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Now these numbers are times. And this is the times. So if I am getting 1, 5 times. If I am getting 2, 3 times. If I am getting 3, 5 times. 4, 10 times. 5, 3 times. And 6, 7 times. Okay. मैं आपको दूसरे के एग्जांपल दिखाती हूँ.
Okay, so probability of an event will be 2 by 5. See, many a time they are
giving the answers in the form of decimal also. If it is easy, you can convert it into decimal. अगर आपको बहुत difficulty होती है, मुझे prime number is a 3 है, 7 है, fraction में छोड़ दो, no problem, it is not a mistake. If you are writing in the form, despite it is easy, you can directly convert it into decimal. So it is 4 upon 10, so it will be 0.4. Convert it into decimal. अगर नहीं तो fraction में छोड़ोगे तो भी correct है, it is not wrong. Okay? Now here, this is the way how we are doing it. Sometimes they will ask you the same thing. How many find the probability of getting the correct day, number of days? So that we can take it by 30 upon. So for correct, if we are finding probability of an event, that is, we will get 30 upon 15, that is 3 by 5. And sum of events, if we take 3 by 5 plus 2 by 5, it will be equal to 1. But उन्होंने नहीं पूछा है तो हमें ये सब नहीं करना है. जितना पूछेगा वही करना है, बिकॉज ये आता है 2 मार्क के सेक्शन में, 3 मार्क के सेक्शन में, ऐसा खत्म क्वेश्चन. ओके, नाउ दिस इज व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न इन दिस लेसन. फर्स्ट वन, दैट इज हाउ मेनी टाइम्स द थिंग्स हैज बीन गिवन, वी हैव टू फर्स्ट रिकॉर्ड इट. सेकेंड, वॉट इज द टोटल, वी हैव टू चेक इट, बिकॉज डिनोमिनेटर में टोटल ही रखना है. और उसके बाद में उसके हिसाब से सम्स करना. But I will do some exercise questions with you, and some questions I will give you as homework. In our next video, we will do exercise question. This was just an example question so that you get familiar with what is probability. Okay, now I am stopping over here. We will continue with exercise 15.1 in our next lecture. There are some of the questions I will do, and I will give you 2-3 questions as homework also. Okay, thank you for watching.